Hello everyone, this is Mr. Kaviani, and by the end of this video you should be able to describe rotational motion, calculate the angular velocity and angular acceleration of an object, and solve problems using the kinematic equations for rotational motion. Alright, now before we jump into rotational motion, I'd like to pause and take a moment to compare and contrast the different types of motion we've looked at so far in this course. The first type of motion we studied was what we called linear or translational motion. Linear motion was the type of motion where objects were moving in one dimension at a time, essentially horizontally or vertically. And we expanded on this to study projectile motion, which was just linear motion in two directions at the same time. After studying linear motion, we started to study circular motion, that is the motion of an object in a circular path around a point that was not part of that object. So in the case of a vertical roller coaster loop, this roller coaster train cart was orbiting in a circular path, if you will, around a point in the middle of this roller coaster track. And so we called this circular motion. All right, now circular motion and rotational motion are very similar, except for the fact that in rotational motion, what we're now talking about is the motion of an object in a circular path where the center of that circle is part of that object. So if we think about the blades of a windmill, or the vanes as they're called, of a windmill, those vanes are rotating, and they are rotating about a point at the center of the vanes. So that is part of the blade, right? It's not rotating about a point outside of its body, it's rotating about a fixed point inside or at the center of its body. And so rotational motion is going to deal with how objects rotate around a point that's part of their body. We could also, if you were to just think about one point on the end of the windmill blade, like let's say you just stuck a flag or a sticker on the end of the windmill blade, you could consider that object to be undergoing circular motion if you consider it separate from the vanes of the windmill. And so in that regards, they're not entirely different things. Circular motion is really just a very specific type of rotational motion. All right, now oftentimes we're not dealing with only one form of motion at a time. And so we'll also discuss what we're going to call rolling motion, which is really nothing more than a combination of linear or translational motion and rotational motion. And a really great example of this is riding a bike. Right? When you ride a bike, the wheels of the bike are rotating, but if you're standing on the sidewalk and watching a bicyclist go by, you see that they, their bike, and their wheels are also all moving through space in a way that is linear. And so we would say that the wheels of that bike are both rotating, right? And they're also moving linearly through space. And so we'll call this rolling. Now, while all of these types of motions may seem very different, throughout these series of videos, we'll see how the different variables we've already defined, position, velocity, and acceleration, can be expanded to define rotational and rolling motion in a way that is very similar to how we've already defined them for linear or translational motion. Now, in case you're wondering why we care to study rotational motion, it's because rotation is everywhere we look. We see Olympic ice skaters making use of the principles of rotational motion to help them land amazing jumps and tricks. We see Olympic divers using principles of rotational motion to help them also perform really impressive dives involving lots of different kinds of rotation. Rotational motion is how baseball pitchers are able to throw such impressive curveballs and baseballs that move through the air. It's the same way that this soccer player down below is able to kick that impressive curved soccer kick, making use of the rotation of the soccer ball, right? It's how people, maybe back in the day, maybe today, listened to music on vinyl records and record players replaced in modern times with CDs and DVDs. And it's also what the Earth is doing, and that's why we have seasons, actually, right? Is because the Earth is rotating about an axis through its center. I'd like to point out the Earth here. This diagram on the right is not to scale. But the Earth is not only rotating, right, about an axis through its center, but it is also undergoing circular motion, and we saw that previously. So the Earth is traveling in a circular path around the sun, where the gravitational force of attraction between the Earth and the sun is acting as the centripetal force. However, the Earth is also undergoing rotational motion as it is rotating through the axis right through its center, essentially, and the Earth is a bit tilted in this case. So I just wanted to point out that rotation is everywhere, and there are many different examples of rotational motion in the case of Earth, of rotational and circular motion that we're all familiar with on a day-to-day basis. And so this unit will help us understand these different types of rotational motion examples at a very deep level.